Well, congratulations. How does this moment feel now, knowing you're a UFC fighter?
Thank you. It feels strange. I can't describe it in words. I don't think it's have gotten into my brain yet, but yeah, the feeling I have now is a relief. It just feels good. It's what I've been training for, and yeah, now I'm here.
When you thought about this moment, I'm sure you've thought about it for a long time. Does this moment live up to that, or do you feel like it's better, different? How are you feeling in terms of just what you imagine this moment being like?
I haven't imagined it so much, but of course you imagine it should be on a certain way, but the feeling is you can't describe it. What you've been working for all your life has come true, and it takes time to the emotion to sink in. So I probably, when I wake up tomorrow, I can feel what I really feel.
And you've accomplished this goal of yours now. What's the next goal? Because I can imagine you probably have a long list of goals. What's the next immediate goal for you in terms of your career?
The next goal is, of course, my first UFC debut, my first fight. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. So we have to see who I'm facing and when it's going to be.
Do you have any thoughts on when you would like that to happen? You know, a card you'd like to fight on, or a person you'd like to fight, or maybe a date?
It doesn't really matter, but of course it would be fun if UFC come to Sweden. I think it's a lot of Swedes that wants it, that UFC can come to Sweden. It's big for us. You know, we have Alexander Gustafsson is a legend and in MMA. So now we starting to get some more Swedes in the UFC. So maybe we can get it back. I don't know. First opponent in my UFC debut. Maybe I have Oban Elliott. I think that would be a good fight.
We were joking back here. We were wondering how many times you're asked if you're related to Alexander Gustafsson.
Yeah, I'm getting tired of this. It's so fucking lame. It's a common surname in Sweden, last name. I think 50% of the Swedes' last name is Gustafsson. So yeah. I don't know what to say about it, but I don't take it the wrong way. Gustafsson is one of the greatest fighters from Sweden in the UFC. So, yeah, I don't mind if people think I'm related to him.
Just say you're not related, but you taught him everything he knows.
Yeah, exactly.
What about your opponent? What did you think of him? Was it surprising in there with him, or did you anticipate the fight going the way it did?
Yeah, I was a bit surprised of his strange strength. I didn't think he should be so strong. I think he was more kind of that striking opponent. But he had a good defense against my wrestling, so I had better condition, better strength, and in the second round I managed to maintain the pace I had and maul him down. A fucking warrior. I really like that guy. I feel for him. I think I know how he feels about losing a UFC contract. I know how I should feel. You put everything into this fight. So many hours, so many months of training, and it didn't go his way. So I feel for him. I really do. He's a great guy, great fighter, good striker. But it was my turn this time.
I'm just wondering, when you were sitting there and listening to Dana start to talk about your fight, were you worried that he was setting up for you not to get a contract, or were you pretty confident you were getting one?
I was not so worried because how I finished the fight, I think that was the you know, haven't I finished the fight like that? Maybe I haven't got the contract, but it was a boring first round from my side. Much wrestling, not so much damage, but in the second round I keep myself going and could deal much more damage and make the fight interesting with the elbows and knees. So I think that the second round was that saved my contract. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you very much.
Yeah.